Spirit. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Brothers and sisters, this is our Mass today for Teresa Smith, who died 1 year ago. And in this Mass, we will use the new prayers which the Holy See, the Vatican, has sent just yesterday. The Mass for this time of pandemic. As you will hear these new prayers, they are especially asking God to help us in this time, to help us way through it, and for us to be spared and to be liberated by all these afflictions by which we are now, in a sense, assaulted, both in body and in mind, both alone individually and as a community, as a society. Let us prepare ourselves for the sacred mysteries, call to mind our sins, and ask God's mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, our refuge in every danger, to whom we turn in our distress. In faith we pray, look with compassion on the afflicted, grant eternal rest to the dead, comfort to mourners, healing to the sick, peace to the dying, strength to healthcare workers, wisdom to our leaders, and the courage to reach out to all in love, so that together we may give glory to your holy name, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
In distress, Jeremiah raised his voice to the Lord. O Lord, you have enticed me, and I was enticed. You have overpowered me, and you have prevailed. I have become a laughingstock all day long. Everyone mocks me. For I hear many whispering, terror is all around. Denounce him, let us denounce him. All my close friends are watching for me to stumble. Perhaps he can be enticed, and we can prevail against him, and take our revenge on him. But the Lord is with me like a dread warrior. Therefore my persecutors will stumble, and they will not prevail. They will be greatly shamed, for they will not succeed. Their eternal dishonor will never be forgotten. O Lord of hosts, you test the righteous. You see the heart and the mind. Let me see your retributions upon them, for to you I have committed my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has delivered the life of the needy from the hands of evildoers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
I love you, O Lord, my strength. The Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer. My God, my rock, in whom I take refuge.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
The Lord is my shield and the source of my salvation, my struggle. I call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised, so I shall be saved from my enemies.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
The torrents of death encompassed me, of Sheol entangled me. The snares of death confronted me.
In my distress I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
In my distress I called upon the Lord. To my God I cried for help. From his temple he heard my voice, and my cry to him reached his ears.
In my distress I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. The Jews took up stones to stone him. Jesus replied, I have shown you many good works from the Father. For which of these are you going to stone me? The Jews answered, It is not for a good work that we are going to stone you, but for blasphemy. Because you, though only a human being, are making yourself God. Jesus answered, Is it not written in your law, I said, you are gods? If those to whom the word of God came were called gods, and the scripture cannot be annulled, can you say that the one whom the Father has sanctified and sent into the world is blaspheming because I said, I am God's son? If I am not doing the works of my Father, then do not believe me. But if I do them, even though you do not believe me, believe the works, so that you may know and understand that the Father is in me and I am in the Father. Then they tried to arrest Jesus again, but he escaped from their hands. He went away again across the Jordan, to the place where John had been baptizing earlier, and he remained there. Many came to Jesus, and they were saying, John performed no sign, but everything that John said about this man was true. And many believed in him there. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. As the reading today says, simply in a sense, and yet powerfully, Jeremiah raised his voice to the Lord. That is in fact exactly what we are doing. Anytime we pray, every time we pray, and especially when we come together to celebrate the Eucharist. In fact, we do more. The Eucharist is the prayer of Jesus, the sacrifice of Jesus, that he raises together with us and for us to God the Father. The prayer of the Mass itself is a prayer to God the Father. That is clear from the texts that are in the Missal, also those that now we have received just yesterday from the Pope, the Holy See. These prayers are addressed to God the Father, to whom we turn in our distress, as it literally says. The we here is really everyone. Not only everyone in the church, among those who believe, but it also becomes clear that in these days, though we are so few, many priests totally alone in celebrating the Mass, we are really all human beings. To them, to everyone, Christ was sent. Strongly he emphasizes in the reading from the Gospel today that he is the one that is sent, the one that is sent to all, the only Son of God, able to make us all sons and daughters, children of God. The one also that we need to invoke for those who are particularly afflicted by the virus that goes around the world. And not only those who are physically afflicted, but also everyone else who suffers spiritually and often psychologically. And there are many of those, and they will get more and more. All of us are somehow afflicted by a fear of suffering, a fear of illness, a fear of dying, for ourselves and for those who care most about. We try to do a lot by doing very little, right? Limiting our lives as much as possible, that is the great contribution we make. We should be, in a sense, amazed at how much we are able to pull off. Much medicine and science and services and all these things working together are able to achieve, and yet, as we see how much that is, we will come to our limits. In fact, we will discover where these limits are. Probably we'll push those limits a bit further. But that will also make it clearer, perhaps, than it has been, that still there are these limits and limitations, which we cannot overcome. There is a limit to what we can do and what we can achieve. It's a big temptation to believe in some kind of almighty state and into some kind of science that knows all things and is able to do all things. No serious politician and no real scientist will say or promise anything like that, but the many fake ones out there. We cannot manage everything. Cannot prevent everything. Some things we will need to bear together, patiently in a sense, and strongly. Indeed, we need to discover that in order to do that, what we need to rediscover is our faith in the one who is beyond all those limits. The one who is truly omniscient, he knows everything, and omnipotent, his power is infinite, his mercy is infinite, it includes those who are dying and who are dead. Let us reconnect and recommit ourselves to him as we celebrate the Eucharist, as we participate in Christ's sacrifice today.
Our sacrifice in your sight this day, and pleasing to you, Lord.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice of my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church. Accept, O Lord, the gifts we offer in this time of care. May they become for us, by your power, a source of healing and peace. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received the heart to profess the infinite power of your Majesty. Since the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed, and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition to Jesus Christ, the Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless his gifts, his offerings, his holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church, for peace to grant, for peace to God, and I now and throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope and Terence, our Bishop, and all those who hold into the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, for they offer it for themselves and all who are given to them, the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, pay your homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory may remain, especially glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul and you and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept the oblation of ourselves and of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. We please, O Lord, we pray, to bless and honor to the proof this offering in every respect, made it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to your Lord, his Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he sent a blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with us. Come and pray with us, Almighty God. Command these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and every blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have come before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant, O Lord, we pray, those who be Christ a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, to those sinners, hoping your abundant mercies, graciously grant us and share the worship with the holy apostles and martyrs, which are the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, the glorious saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company. Weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these two things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always and with your spirit.
May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be. Come to me, all who labor and are burdened, and I will refresh you, says the Lord.
may glory in the fullness of heavenly healing through Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, protector of all who hope in you, bless your people, keep them safe, defend them, prepare them, that free from sin and safe from the enemy, they may persevere always in your love through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go glorify the Lord by your lives. Thanks be to God. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. To thou, Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, see